one of the students that I tutor enjoys analyzing political speeches and studying the rhetoric and the language used within them, and also diagramming sentences. When he tried to diagram parts of a recent speech, he realized that he didn't have all the skills yet to complete the task. So the next lesson for us was objective compliments. And here we go. So an objective compliment can be an adjective or a noun that completes the verb, it finishes the meaning of the verb, and it also modifies the direct object in some way. So if there is no direct object, there will be no objective complement. Let's take a look at two sentences to make this a little more clear. Johnny painted his old purple jalopy versus Johnny painted his old jalopy purple. So in the first sentence, what color is Johnny's old jalopy now? Well, we don't know. In the second sentence, we know that his old jalopy is now purple. And here we diagram the first version. Johnny painted what? Painted jalopy. That's the direct object. Whose jalopy? His jalopy. What kind of jalopy? Old jalopy. What kind? A purple jalopy. So these are all adjectives. As opposed to in sentence two, Johnny painted his old jalopy purple. So we still have Johnny painted, and then the direct object is jalopy. But purple in this case answers the question, painted how? So he painted the jalopy how? He painted it purple. And you'll see that purple modifies jalopy, but it also completes the action of the verb. And this is how we diagram an object complement. After the direct object, we have a slanted line pointed back over jalopy toward painted. And then the object complement goes on a straight line after the slanted line. Let's look at another one. Mom cooked her famous salty pork again versus Mom cooked her famous pork salty again. The first sentence, salty, is functioning as an adjective modifying pork, the noun, which is in the direct object position. It's telling us what kind of pork. In the second sentence, salty, is telling us how Mom cooked the pork. Pork is the direct object because it answers the what question. Mom cooked what? Pork. Mom cooked the pork how? She cooked the pork salty. Here's another set of sentences to compare. Look at object complements. He was elected class president by his classmates. He, subject, was elected, verb, president, is the predicate noun. You'll see that president follows the linking verb. President points back to he. President tells us something about the subject. Now, how about this one? His classmates elected him class president. Now, classmates are doing the action. So, classmates is the subject. Verb is elected, and the direct object is him. They elected him. But they elected him what? President. So, president here is the objective complement. And as we have said, the objective complement could be an adjective, as it has been in the past cases, or here it can be a noun. So president is completing the verb elected, and it's also telling us about him. Sentence three, his classmates elected him as their class president again. Sometimes we will see this construction, which is similar but slightly different from the second one. Again, classmates is the subject. They elected him, him being the direct object, and president is the noun version of the objective complement. Which kind of president? Class president. Who's president? their president. And then as is an expletive, we'll get into that later, but it sits up there on its own line above the objective complement. Okay, so let's try some of these out, because the best way to learn is to do. Let's begin. We have five sentences here plus a bonus, and the directions are to diagram the five sentences unless the sentence does not currently have an objective complement. If it does not, figure out a way to rewrite it so that it does have an objective complement. Good luck, have fun, and enjoy. Okay, but first let's diagram one together. So let's look at sentence number one. Louise found the math test quite difficult. Okay, so the subject we know is Louise. She's the one doing the action here. What did she do? She found what? She found the test. Okay, so test is the direct object. Which test? The test. What kind of test? She found the math test quite difficult. So here we have some adjectives. And then the objective complement here is, she found the test how? She found it difficult. So it fits in just like this. How difficult? Quite difficult. The math test was much more difficult than diagramming the sentence. So go ahead and do the rest. Good luck and enjoy. And here are some answers and possible answers for our five statements. So we reviewed number one. Let's look at number two. The roof kept the stranded guests warm and dry. So here is a rewrite of the original sentence, which said the guests were kept warm and dry by the roof. So in order to get an objective complement, we need a direct object. So we make roof the subject, doing the action. What did the roof do? The roof kept what? Or kept who? Kept the guests. So there's our direct object. And here we have a compound objective complement, adjective style. Yeah, kept the guests how? Warm and dry. Okay, let's look at number three. Again, here's a version of a rewrite. Remember, you have to rewrite it so that you can get a direct object, because you can't have an objective complement without a direct object. So here's one version. The new chef made the chili spicier. The chef is the subject, actively making chili spicier. So chili is the direct object. Made the chili how? Made it spicier. Number four. Here's another one we had to rewrite. And we end up with, from that day, the people called the firemen heroes. Again, we need to have a direct object, otherwise you can't have an objective complement. And this time our objective complement is a noun. So let's look. The people is the subject. What did they do? They called who or what? They called the firemen, direct object. Called the firemen what? So there's an adjective question. And the answer is heroes. So heroes is the objective complement here. And when did this happen? From that day. So they called when? And here's an old adverb question. Called when? Answer, from that day. Five, the residents of York find Albonian long dragons just dreamy. Who doesn't? So the residents find long dragons dreamy. And there we have the same structure that we've been looking at. Dreamy is the adjective version of an objective complement. It's telling us how the residents find the long dragons. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that. How'd you do? But we have one more bonus to look at. But before we look at the bonus question, we're going to look at one little project that was made with the student that I mentioned earlier. He's a big fan of political speech, and he wanted to diagram a section from a recent speech. But I said, that's not something I can use in these videos. I like to play it down the middle. I like to kind of avoid the political stuff. But he said, don't worry about it. I have a solution for you. And it was pretty funny. So I'll share that solution with you now.
Together we will make America strong again. We will make America wealthy again. We will make America proud again. We will make America safe again. And yes, together we will make America great again.
The kids today, what can I tell you? Well, here we have the answer to our bonus question. Together, we will make diagramming interesting again. We will make diagramming comprehensible again. We will make diagramming fun again. And yes, together, we will make diagramming great again. So we see in this compound sentence, all four clauses share the same verb, share the same subject, share the same direct object, in fact, but differ when it comes to objective complements. Each objective complement functions as an adjective, adding more information or modifying the direct object. And the direct object is in the form of a gerund. As we know, gerunds are words that are made from verbs that end in ing, but now function either as a noun or as an adjective. And you'll see that they're functioning as nouns in each of these direct objects. So the subject we verb will make direct object diagramming. Objective complement, interesting. How will we make diagramming interesting? Together. When? Again. We will make diagramming comprehensible. When? Again. Make it fun. When? Again. And yes, interjection sits there above on its own line. And yes, we will make diagramming great. Again. How? Together. Well, I hope you enjoyed this lesson on objective complements. This will really round out your toolbox. And now you can diagram most sentences that you will meet out in the world. But of course, there's still more to learn. And I hope to see you again the next time. Have a good one.